YouTube, team, keep it clean. Let me fix this so we can get started and I won't look too shiny. But what's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. Ooh, that's a little too dark now. But in this video, we got a live stream. We're here live. Ooh, there goes the orange me. Anyway, we'll just leave it at that. It ain't no big deal. And let's go. Let's get it, man. But in this live stream, and good evening to everybody. Appreciate y'all coming through. Whether you watching this live or you watching this as a regular video, thank you all for joining us. Thank you all for being a part of this. And thank you all for just rocking out with us. What's up, Chris 2 Wavy, Sean Slaughter. And appreciate y'all. Appreciate y'all. I guess y'all got a notification for this. So that's always a good thing when YouTube decides it wants to act correctly. That's always a beautiful thing. And trust me, because it's... It's like being at a job, and when, I mean, you know how your job is supposed to function. You know some basic functions of your company, and it's like if that company that you work for isn't going through those basic functions, if they're not completing those basic functions that they should be completing on a day-to-day basis and they're capable of it, but sometimes they just don't do it, it can be frustrating at work. So that's the same way it is with YouTube, for people that do YouTube. When them notifications don't go out, especially when the people that are watching the videos, when they turn all the notifications on, it can be very frustrating. But anyway, it is what it is. So that's why I say follow on Twitter. Make sure you follow on Twitter, because every single video, whether you get the notification or not, every single video, every single one, we put it on Twitter. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, everything is Engraven Vids. Of course, the YouTube channel. Everything matches each other. So everything is Engraven Vids. Everything. So you can follow on there if you want to. Appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And we have purple merch now. We have purple merch. So the link to the purple merch is down below in the description. I know some people had been asking about why you don't have anything in purple. Why you ain't got nothing in purple? But we have stuff in purple now. So it's down below in the description. And the other merch is down below in the description as well. If you ever want to send something to the P.O. Box, like I say, that's down below in the description. Questions from subscribers, if you want to be part of that, you send an email to teamkeepitclean@gmail.com. That's it. There ain't really much to say after that. But anyway, what's going on, P&S team? What's up, Showcase? Jordan, what's going on, man? Does anybody know when the schedule's coming out? I saw something in the Ravens group chat that said it was coming out in like May or something like that, or June. I forgot. But anyway, in Brazil, what's up, Matias? What's going on? One of my boys just had a son a little less than a year ago, and he named him Matias. So yeah. Oh, they doing it next month in May? Okay. Somebody said April. Somebody said May. Either way, I guess I had to find out myself, because it seemed like don't nobody know. Anyway, and if you want to donate to the channel, that's in the description too. Shout out to my guy, because I got to give him a big shout out, man. My guy, where is he at? I was just looking at him. My guy Xavier Lopez, man. I appreciate the donation, because he donated on Cash App to the channel. So I appreciate that a lot, man. So thank you. So shout out to Xavier Lopez, man. Hopefully you're watching this, but I thank you for that. Anyway, y'all saw the title of the video. What is the biggest challenge that the Ravens face now? And we are about 2 weeks, not even removed from free, or 2 weeks removed from the start of free agency. Because free agency, again, like I always say, that's something that is literally all year long, all season long. Free, what's up, Mike B? What's going on, man? Free agency is all year long. It's not anything that just is in March for a couple weeks. It's all the entire season, because teams, they are always making moves. I mean, especially Ravens. Y'all saw it firsthand with Eric DaCosta. This dude was literally making moves all season long. All season long. All season long. What's up, Flex? And that's why I say free agency is not just in the off season. It's during the season too. But we are 2 weeks removed from the start of free agency. And we are a little bit before the draft. So I know a lot of people's answer to this question may vary. And of course, like always, we may have different opinions on what the answer to this question is. But what is the Ravens' biggest challenge? Well, let's go piece by piece. Shout out to Nicholas Wallace, because he's on the same wavelength that I am too. But piece by piece. So free agency started. So what do you do in free agency? Well, free agency, you address some different holes on the roster. This free agency, they went heavy defense. What's up, Jordan? They went heavy defense. They tried Michael Brockers. That obviously didn't work out. It's all good, though. They moved on. They traded for Calais Campbell. That was good. They brought back DeAnthony Thomas. Give him another opportunity there. Worst case scenario, it doesn't work out. Okay, he's gone. They brought back Chris Moore. He's a good special teams player as a receiver. He's kind of iffy, but they brought him back. Low deal. If it doesn't work out, okay, move on. I don't think it's really a big deal or a bad deal that they brought those guys back. They just want to go into the season having some guys that they know at some different positions where they may be comfortable with those guys. They may not be the best that the Ravens can get, but they're comfortable with those guys. What's up, Brandon? So they decided, you know what, we'll bring them back. And again, worst case scenario, doesn't work out. Okay, that's it. Ravens will move on. They've done it before plenty of times. They brought back Anthony Levine, providing them some safety depth. So that was good. And he's a Swiss Army knife. He can come in and play multiple positions. So that's always a good thing when you can do that. They brought back Jimmy Smith, who is a really good corner. Has some health issues, but he got an incentivized-based contract. But the base of the contract is, what, $3.5 million? And he got a chance for it to go up to $6 million or up to $6.5 million. I forgot. But about $3 million or $3.5 million of his contract is based on playing time. It's based on playing time. So it's like, I don't know how Eric DeCosta be doing it, but I ain't complaining about nothing. Nothing at all. Hey, K, what's up, man? What's going on, man? Shout out to my guy, man. When's the next players ball? We definitely drafting a pass rusher. I would like to draft Swift. We'll see. But so with free agency, they've done some things. And again, they just recently signed Derek Wolf, so that was a good move. So their free agency has been primarily on defense. Got one special teamer. What's up, Marquise? Got one special teamer. And hopefully, not even hopefully. They could be done. Not necessarily done, but done with the bigger signings. But we'll see. We'll see, because again, a lot depends on what they're going to do with Matt Judon. And I think we'll know more of that after the draft. After the draft, I think we should have a clear indication on what they're going to do with Matt Judon. Because they will either have traded him by then, or they will still keep him by then. Or we can get some indications depending on how they draft. I think that will tell a big story. How the Ravens draft, that will tell a big story on how they feel about Matt Judon. Some other moves that they made, they gave the restricted free agent tenders to both Gus Edwards and Matt Skura. And that lets you know how the Ravens felt about them. I believe Gus Edwards got a low round tender too. But yeah, Matt Skura, he got a low round tender too. So I mean, I think that lets you know that with the Ravens, hey, we like you, but we aren't afraid to do this thing without you. Just in case somebody signed them to an offer sheet, and they signed that offer sheet, and then the Ravens didn't match, they would lose both players, and they would not get compensation for either of the two. So they also brought back Andre Smith on a cheap deal. What's up, Mr. Smith Vlogs? Hope you and your girl are doing good, man. And your kids, too, man. Appreciate you coming through. Make sure y'all leave a like on the video, too. We got 100 people in here, but only 17 likes. What? I ain't do nothing to nobody. Even though I know a lot of y'all got so mad. Like, real quick, let's address this real quick. Because I talk about it in the video that we got coming out probably tomorrow or something. But since we in here right now, we might as well talk about it real quick. There was a lot of y'all that got so mad over a question from a subscriber about the title question. Should the Ravens think about getting Cam Newton as a backup? So many people got so mad. I'm like, really? Is it really that serious? And some of y'all even got like disrespectful to the people that was to the person that asked the question. I'm like, come on now, man. It ain't that serious. It's never that serious. It's never that serious, baby. Because, again, the thing with questions from subscribers, like, that's an open forum for Team Keep It Clean. That's an open forum for people to ask whatever type of question they want to ask. Whether it's a hypothetical question, whether it's a realistic question, or whether it's something that's hypothetical at the moment, but it could turn into something realistic. Whatever it is, it's like so many people, they get so mad over a question, over a hypothetical question. And I'll never understand that, and I'll never get it, and I'll never agree with it either. But anyway, it's not that serious. It's not everybody. Oh, yeah, no, Kev, it ain't everybody. But it's a lot. And that's not what Team Keep It Clean is about. Some people even started getting disrespectful, and I'm like, for me, I don't care. If you want to say engraving, oh, that's stupid, blah, blah, blah. To me, I don't care. But to the person that asked the question, I don't like that. I don't like that. Because me, I'm not sensitive, so it ain't going to bother me none. But you don't know what somebody, and I'm not trying to make it bigger than what it is. But at the same time, you don't know what somebody on the other side of the screen is going through. You don't know what somebody in the comment section is going through. And with these questions, people are put on, exactly, thank you. Baltimore Best said the question doesn't mean it's going to happen. Exactly. It's a question from subscriber. Thank you. But you don't know what the person who asked the question is going through. You don't know if they're going through something or not. And they may come here to just chill. They may come here to just vibe and whatnot. Come take a break from everything going on in the world. And then they see all these people getting on them about their question. And it's like, really? That ain't Team Keep It Clean, man. I just thought that was just dumb. But anyway. So they went through a free agency. And that's where we are now. Did we miss any signings that they did through free agency? I don't think we did. No, I don't think we did. Oh, and they traded away Hayden Hurst. So there goes another hole there. So Ravens, what's up, Double R? They've been super, super active during this free agency. A lot of people didn't expect them to. Especially the way that they've been active. Like, they've been, like, active. What's up, Jay Frank? What's going on, man? So is the challenge for them filling holes? Some may say, hey, well, they did all this stuff on defense. They still got a big challenge to fill holes on offense. And while they technically do, I don't think it's big holes that they got to fill on offense, because they got... The offensive line is a little bit of a question mark. They got some possible, the long snapper signing. Thank you. Appreciate that. Who that, Chickers? Oh, yeah, that is Chickers. I forgot about that. They signed a long snapper from XFL. So, I'm sure they just want to give Morgan Cox a break. What's up, Mike? During, like, training camp, whenever we do get there. So we'll see. We'll see. I did hear that, what is it, Virginia? Virginia got to stay in the house till June? I don't know if that was real or not. But I did see that thing where they got like they were told they need to stay in the house till June. So if that's true, wow, big yikes. And the post said because they were all at the beach or something, they weren't listening. I don't know. You know, don't nobody nowadays listen to anything. Appreciate it, Trevino. Thank you. We set a tackle for the next 10 years. Okay, I guess so, man. We'll see. We ain't got nobody signed for the next 5. So, he said, I can confirm that I'm out here in Virginia. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, so it is real. Okay. I wasn't sure. Illinois got extended to April 30th. Okay, so they're doing it state by state. Oh, a lot of y'all from Virginia in here. Okay. Appreciate y'all. Maryland got an indefinite shelter. Oh, man. All right. So, that's free agency. But, yeah, so could the biggest challenge be filling holes on offense via free agency? Yeah, I don't think so. And then you can question the draft, since we got the draft coming up. Now, one big challenge that the Ravens do have for the draft, they can't do the pre-draft visits. Now, somebody, I forgot who it was in the comment section of a video where that was one of the questions from subscribers where somebody asked, oh, do you think that... that with the whole thing going on and them not being able to have the pre-draft visits, or how is everything going on going to affect the draft? And I said that the pre-draft visits, those are big. Because with the pre-draft visits, yeah, you can see what you want to see on the game film from watching the tape and all that, from seeing how they play, blah, blah, blah. That's cool. But then the pre-draft visits, that's your opportunity to really get to know them, to really get to talk to them one-on-one, personal. Because it's different. Like, you could talk to somebody on the phone. You could FaceTime with them on the phone. But it's not the same as actually being there in person. It's not the same. So it's different when you're in person. Because some people on the phone, they may be like, hey, what's up, baby? How you doing? Da, 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 da. But then in person, they may be like. So it's just a way for you to really get to see their personality and really get to really get a good vibe about them. So I think that's a big part of it. And it's a way to help with sort of a smokescreen too. Jeff said anyone with character issues will be a riskier pick if you haven't interviewed them. I'll bet we see a bunch of them slide down draft boards. Ooh. Mmm. Hey, and you can get put on Front Street right there too. Because if you're on the phone, somebody asks you a personal question on the phone or something like that, you can answer one way on the phone. But if you're right there in person, they can get really a better feel for if you're lying or not. They can get a better feel for how comfortable you are with that question. And you know, them pre-draft visits, they ask all sorts of questions. All sorts of questions. But now that's going to be restricted to FaceTime. That's going to be restricted to over the phone. That's going to be restricted to all of that. So it's going to be very different. This draft is going to be very different this year. And we're going to see how it all works out. It's going to be interesting nonetheless. Also the smoke screens. The smoke screens, because sometimes teams will use visits to throw other teams off from who they're interested in drafting. They'll do that. They'll bring in this player when they're really, really interested in that player, but they'll still bring in this player because this player is a, what's up, wrestling guy? This player is a player that a lot of people may feel like that team needs and that team may want, but they're really interested in that player. So they might bring them both in. And then bring in somebody else. And then they also do it just so they can have more options. They can really get to know these guys. They can have way more options. So it does impact it. Because I know somebody in the comment section was like, hey, bro, no, the only thing that matters is the tape. That's it. No, it's not. It's not. So anyway, because you look at it like a job. You look at it like a job. It's all good, Inani. What's going on, man? We only been here 18 minutes, so you know we ain't start nothing yet. You know how it goes. But you look at it like a job, because with a job, if you perform good at your previous jobs, that's fine. That's great. But you still got to go through the interview process. You still got to go through the interview process. And they still want to get to know you. What you done at your previous jobs is cool. That's great. And that says a lot. But they still got to get to know you personally. So it's definitely important. So too bad, man. That's like AB being happy on the phone, but in person, he's a mad dog. This guy, man. Oh, boy. but anyway, so the draft, they got some things that they can issue. I mean, that they can address via the draft. Obviously, it's going to be different. We still streaming, nonetheless. We still going to be doing our day one draft stream, so y'all make sure y'all come through for that. What's up, Stay Focused? Y'all make sure y'all come through for that, because we always have a lot of fun doing that first round of the draft. It goes on a long time, because some of these teams, it's like they be trolling, and it's like, man, come on, go ahead and put your pick in. We know you got it already. Put your pick in, please. And they just be sitting there, taking forever, especially the teams with the number one pick. The teams with the number, I don't know why they do it every year. The teams with the number one pick, they wait and they wait. What's up, Neek? They wait and 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 they wait. They use all 15 minutes. It's like you had a whole pre-draft show that NFL be showing. You had the whole intro to the draft that NFL be showing. And then you had a whole nother 15 minutes. You knew who you were going to get. You know who you were gonna get. So what's the point? What's the point in doing all that? You ain't gotta take all that time to do that. So It is what it is, man. But anyway, we'll see how that goes, man. It's going to be, I think Roger Goodell is still announcing the picks, I believe. But with that being said, no. My guy Bobby Palmer just asked me, should they bring Tony Jefferson back at a cheaper price? No, not at all. They need to move on. And they have moved on. So, no. No need. No need. What's up, coach? It's funny, we just had a, I think it's in a video that I'm going to be putting out tomorrow. We had a question from subscribers. Somebody asked me about Cushenberry. They asked me about Cushenberry. And I had to give you a big shout out, and I sent them on your way. So when that video comes out, I believe it'll come out tomorrow. Just know that they'll be coming your way. Because I told them that I said, Coach, if it was up to him, he would draft this guy number one overall. He loved Cushenberry. I ain't say all that, not the number one overall part, but you get what I mean. They know you got a love for Cushenberry, man. So, yeah, man. So that's tomorrow, I believe. But anyway. Whew. So the draft. Is the draft the Ravens' biggest challenge now? Are they going to draft a good receiver? Are they going to draft a good inside linebacker? Are they going to draft some good offensive linemen like Cushenberry? Are they going to draft some good tight end? What are they going to do? What are they going to do? But I still don't even think that's the biggest challenge. Not to me. Mm-mm. No, no, no. Logan said in the draft, would you rather draft a hybrid speed linebacker like Queen or run stuff and blitzer like Bond? Probably a hybrid. But can Queen shed blocks though? Is he strong? Is he able to get those offensive linemen off of him or fullbacks off of him? Can Ravens sign Martavius Bryant? I forgot about Martavius Bryant. I don't even know if he's in. I can't say in-stated. Is that even a word? I don't even know if he's in the league right now. I don't even know. So, No clue. But, yeah, so is the draft the Ravens' biggest challenge now? No, not even. Is this whole Brandon Cooks? No. I mean, Brandon, he's not a bad receiver. But just, again, the concussions, they just scare me. They scare me. Whoa. Hey, appreciate that, Antonio. Thank you, man. It caught me off guard. I saw this big pink thing. I said, oh, wait a minute. Appreciate that a lot, man. Thank you for that. Appreciate it. I read it to myself, but I ain't even read it out loud. He said, thanks for keeping us motivated and continuing the grind. Appreciate that, man. You know, this thing can't stop. I mean, I can't stop because then I will be out of work because this is my job. But nah, I appreciate it though. Seriously, man. Thank you. Carlo, what's up, man? What's going on? Shout out to Carlo, man. Carlo need to have his own podcast, man. Straight up. Carlo need to have his own podcast. Mr. Chad, you are 1,000% correct. Do you think we still getting Mike Daniels? I'm sure they'll keep him on tabs. I think he'll be on a back burner for now, though. I don't think they, you never know with Eric DaCosta, because this dude can get any player he wants. They got about 10 mil in salary cap right now, but they could take that 10 mil. I bet they could get, like, besides the draft, because they got to have like 3 mil or 3.5 mil for the draft. And they like to keep 5 mil in their back pocket, sort of as insurance, just in case they got to bring somebody in. So, man, I bet. So that will leave like, what, 1.5, 2 mil left over? Eric DaCosta could do it, man. Eric DaCosta could do it. He could get, for 2 mil, Eric DaCosta will find a way to get Clowney, Clay, and Griffin. Jadeveon Clowney, Clay Matthews, and Everson Griffin. He will find a way to get all three of them. I don't know what this dude is doing, but I ain't asking no questions. I'm supporting it. I'm supporting it. They need to make EDC shirts. I bet on Amazon they probably selling EDC shirts. So EDC can suit him like Lamar Jackson, too. Don't use that likeness, man. You gotta get clear for that. You got to get clear for it. But yeah, EDC, he's real deal, man. He is real deal. I much respect to him. I love it. That dude is a hustler. And he did say he is from Boston there. So he said a lot of his family are Patriots fans. A lot of his family are Patriots fans. So he got to see, like, he got to see how the Patriots did the NFL for so long. And they, like, Patriots been, they've been doing some stuff now, man. So EDC, he got to, like, learn watching them and stuff. And he was like, okay, you know what? Okay. He was taking his notes and stuff. And he was scratching his bald head. And then he went back to taking his notes again. Appreciate that, Carlo. He said, I'd rather just call in from time to time, no pressure. Oh, yeah, I mean, hey, but if you ever, oh, yeah, I love the aggression, too. If you ever decide to have your own podcast, boy, you got my support, man. You got it, because you on it, man. You on it. So we appreciate you from when you was on with us. I don't know if you called in Sonny's before or even Coach, too, but, man, you be on it, man. You be on it. So if you ever decide to do it, you got my vote, man. You definitely got my vote. So we appreciate you, man. But Eric DaCosta, yeah, I don't know how he been doing this stuff. What's up, Kato? What's up, man? What's going on, man? What's up? What's going on, Sean? My boy Kato. What's going on? Yeah, he do be all over it for real, man. I love it, man. I love it. I like when people I don't know nothing about football, but I love when people can when you can have a conversation, a football conversation with somebody, and they can show you like a completely different, even if it's a subject that you have a lot of information on or knowledge on or whatever, blah blah blah, but I love when somebody can take something that you're talking about and they can show you a completely different side of it that you weren't even thinking of. I absolutely love that. That's why I love Team Keep It Clean. Love people like Carlo, because that's exactly what he does. That's exactly, and it was, I think he was only on here, what is it, just one night? That was just one night. That was just one stream. And this dude was like, he was on it, man. So again, if you ever decide, I'm with it, man. What's up, Sean? If they can get a young talent that can gel, I love it. Nah, ain't nothing, Carlo. Well, no, we appreciate you, man. So, thank you. But yeah, wish Broncos would have worked out. I do too. That wasn't fun. I ain't get mad over it or anything, but I was just like, oh, okay, cool, but I would have rather Brocker stayed. I would have liked that. But it's all good, man. It's fine. It's all good. Derek Wolfe is still good, too, man. Now, again, just health. But he'll be fine. He'll be fine. All he got to do is just go get some crab cakes from Jimmy's. Because, you know, that's where all the free agents go. Even though, I don't know if y'all noticed, I haven't seen Jimmy's on Twitter. I know they doing the... what is called social distancing. But I ain't seen Jimmy's offering no crab cakes. Unless I missed something. I ain't seen Jimmy's offering nobody no crab cakes. Did y'all? Because you know that was the thing. Oh, yeah, hey, free crab cakes for life. I ain't seen none of that. Straight up, man. None of that. So, I guess that's that. But that's fine, man. So y'all haven't seen it either. Cool. Yeah, Jeremy Maclin, he said Jeremy Maclin got him. Even though it ain't work out for his time here with the Ravens, I mean, he still got them free crab cakes. And I think Jimmy, they even tweeted that too. They were like, hey, it's all good. They said we are men of our word. We are men of our word. So you still got the free crab cake anytime you come back. So that's cool, man. Where we at? Oh, so that's the draft. So, anyway, biggest challenge with the Ravens. Let's get down to it. We done been in here 30 minutes, and we talked about all these things that could possibly be challenges. And I have seen some people in the comment section sort of hit on it. But what I think is the biggest challenge for these Baltimore Ravens this year is not assembling a team. It's not building a bully. It's not... if they can develop the talent that they draft. It's not any of that. He said we on Team Keep It Clean. You know how it goes, man. You know how it goes. That's why I say, I'll be trying to tell people, hey, when we stream, you just got to be there. They go up as regular video. What's up, Dre? What's going on, man? They go up as regular videos, but for the people that see them as regular videos, if you weren't there, I can't say nothing, man. I can't say nothing. That's on you. But anyway, what's up, Dominic? Hope everybody keeping safe and secure. Hey, appreciate you, man. We love y'all too, man. But Raven's biggest challenge, somebody earlier said it's themselves. And I was like, well, he said 12-hour vid, let's go. Ooh, that would be something, man. That would be something. I don't even know how long we're going to go tonight. It ain't going to be too long, but, you know, every time we say that. But, nah, it ain't going to be too long. I hope Miles Boykin takes a high leap this year. Ooh, we got a question from subscriber video coming out tomorrow. Well, hopefully it comes out tomorrow because I got a lot of them. I got a lot of questions. Whole lot of questions. Boy, yeah. Let me see how much emails we got now because yesterday I had 75. Today we are at 41 because I've been working on them. What's up? Hey, Sick Kicks, what's up, man? Tommy Watts. Hey, I saw your question, Tommy. A good one. I got you too, man. Well, I already recorded it. It's already on a video, but the video ain't come out yet. So probably tomorrow. What's up, Steve? What's going on, man? But we have, we at 41 now. And I'll knock some off. But then it grows again. So the question from subscribers, videos. I mean, you know, we're going to keep pumping them out. And they may end up getting a little bit longer. They may get a little bit longer because it's just a lot of these questions. Hey, appreciate that, Jordan. No, they ain't got no 19 million caps, but no, they got like 10, man. Ooh, you trying to give out Ravens money, man. You trying to give out Ravens. They ain't got no 19 million no cap space. That'd be nice. They don't have that, though. Ooh. Oh, yeah, I already know, Dre. Appreciate it. My guy said 19 mil, boy. Ooh. You must be related to EDC or something, man. Oh, you know what? You're right. Shaku got it, man. He said under the table money. They must have it. They must have it. But, yeah, them questions from subscribers just, they've been going crazy. And the thing about it, too, it's like I can't ever say either that, all right, this question from subscriber video, we're gonna knock out like 15 questions in this video. I mean, I don't even think, man, have we even done 15 questions in a video? That don't even sound right, but still. But my point in that is that, because with a lot of the questions, they not just like, all right, next question came from such and such. Do you think da 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 da? Yeah, I do. Boom, done. No. You know, don't nobody be asking them quick yes or no questions like that. They be asking these detailed, super loaded questions. Graven, hey, on December 21st, 2021, what do you think the Ravens' record will be if they draft this guy and then they trade this guy and they have this amount of salary cap space and da-da-da? Y'all be coming with it, man. So I can't even plan like, okay, I'm gonna answer this amount of questions in this video because, boy, y'all be on it, man. But I ain't complaining. I love it. Like I always say, man, I absolutely love it. So I appreciate y'all. And again, please, when you get a chance, I know by the time this video is over, you'll probably forget. I can't blame you. But when this video is over, please, please go back. And you can do this from the Question from Subscribers playlist. Please go back and sort it from oldest to newest. So you get the oldest video. See, a question from subscriber video just finished processing just now. Because I had edited it earlier and it just finished processing. I need a new computer. But anyway, you sort it from oldest to newest. And just look how questions from subscribers used to be. Because we used to do one question per video from the car, whether we would be on break or whether we would be... Because whether we'd be on break or whether we'd be off work already. We would do one question per video from the car. And boy, I could never do that now. I could never do that now. Do 41 videos for all these questions? Woo, that would be wild. But I appreciate y'all. And I love y'all, man. And I continue to thank y'all for showing crazy support, man. Seriously, man. Denmark, Oscar, what's up, man? Oh, they just a huge Ravens fan base in Denmark. That's what's up, man. That's what's up. All this stuff needs to go ahead and this stuff needs to go away, man. All this stuff needs to go away. Stuff need to go away, man. Everything going on. We ready to just be out. We ready to just go vibe and whatever. And all this stuff need to be a thing of the past, man. Well, speaking of that, I sent the question in the season. Do you think Ravens should have traded Pierce in the beginning? No, I don't think so. I don't think so. Because, I mean, with Daylon Mack, it was a big question mark there. I remember when the background was, when it was naked, had to set it up. Hey, yeah, man. So even the videos from here, it's just, it's just different, man. And it's crazy. That's why I love to, because I appreciate how things are big time now, man. But when, appreciate it, Oscar. Thank you for doing that, man. Because word of mouth is big. Word of mouth is huge. Because, you know, YouTube ain't really good with word of mouth, man. So I appreciate you doing that, man. Because I appreciate how things are now. But it makes me appreciate it even more when I see them older videos. It makes me appreciate it even more. Because I'm like, even this, like the background and even the colors of the wall. The colors of these walls used to be like some ugly, like tan color, something like that. And then at first I ended up painting it red, and then we ended up painting it that gray. And it just, it's just different. And then, this was plain. None of this stuff was here. I had the stuff, and like when we would go to the training camps and stuff, we would collect the stuff. But so a lot of it I had, some of it I got, but it was not up. But it's just, and then shout out to my guy Sean Searles. I don't know if he's in here right now, but shout out to my guy Sean. Ravens Nation, what up, man? Because he has sent a couple of these. He sent this one right here. Oh, you can't. I'm all in the way. He sent that one. And he sent another one, too. What's the other one he sent? Oh, no. He sent a football. He sent that one, and he sent that football right there for Carter. But I took it. I took it from Carter. So, since Corona came out, Graven been too busy for streams. I just really had ever since after the playoff game, I just hadn't streamed much. Bring it up. I do remember when it was bare. Then slowly but surely, here we are today. Yeah, I mean it's still some more that I want to do. I just gotta get more stuff. But cause I have two more of these. Whoa. I have two more of these. But I don't want to put the same flag up on the wall three times. I think that would look tacky, man. So I just want to get something different. Because I got two more of these that I'm not even using. So, oh no, CJ. That ain't me at all, man. But hey, it is what it is, man. But what's up, CJ? What's going on, man? Think DaCosta could get clowned. Oh. I'm like, what? DaCosta get clowned? For what? But he meant Clowney and Brandon Cooks. DaCosta, he can do anything that he wants to. He can do anything that he wants to. Straight up, man. But anyway, like I was saying, it just it's nice to look back to see how it was. Because no, that's up to you, man. That's up to you, Sick Kicks. If you want to get something, cool. If you don't, cool. Ain't no big deal, man. But it's really nice to look back, man. You need a Ray Lewis replica, what? What you say? Oh, statue. Hold up. I can't go too far back. Oh, this was for my guy Ian Hargrove, man. The little Ray Lewis, man. I can't go too far back. Cause, well, I mean y'all family. I ain't got no shorts on right now, man. I'm chilling, man. I ain't free, but I just ain't got no shorts on right now, man. I just got my boxers, so I can't go too far back, cause then it won't be Team Keep It Clean no more. So this team keep it super chill right now. His team got the stream going, but hey, we're super comfortable right now, man. Y'all know how it is, man. I'm sure a lot of y'all are the same way right now. But only difference is the camera's not on for y'all phones. Anyway. So team, keep it clean, man. Hey, man. Got to, Mike. Because too many people don't. Too many people don't. How you been handling the quarantine? I've been cooling it, man. Because with Carter, he was already here. Because I had been homeschooling Carter already. He was in school till about... Because he started going to school in August, I think. He started going to school in August. And... He started going to school in August, and he stopped in January, I think. Yeah, he stopped in January. He started going to school in August, he stopped in January, and I just ended up homeschooling him. Because the school that he was going to, they were giving me too much problems, man. And it was a different school than the school he was going to before in the summer. Because I don't know, I know a lot of y'all was here, some of y'all weren't. But that's cool. Growth is a great thing. It's a beautiful thing. But, with Carter, I remember the school that he was going to before, during the summer, they had lost his swim shoes and I think a towel that we sent to the school for when they were doing like some swimming thing. And I'm like, really? How do you lose somebody's shoes? Especially if they got their name on them and stuff. How do you do that? And then they end up finding them like a month later. But then with this school, it was just some other problems too. More serious stuff. And so I just say, you know what? I'ma just homeschool. So I've just been homeschooling them. And so we have been doing that, I think, since about January. And so he was already here. And I loved it, man. I loved it. I love it. It can be very frustrating. So I give the teachers, man. Teachers, they are real deal. Some of them need some improvement. But for them to deal with what they deal with. He's great with other kids. Nah, he not like no isolated kid or anything like that. He not like in a bubble or anything like that. But he's fine with other kids. So, but with the homeschool, I like it. I love it because you know exactly what your kid is learning. You know how they're learning it. You know exactly what's going on with them 24/7. Yeah, it can be a little annoying sometimes, but it's your kid. It's your child. I love it. I love it. So we'll see. We'll see how everything else works out. For kindergarten, he'll probably go back to school, back to regular school, whatever. But we'll see. It just depends on how this whole thing is going on. Homeschool is a trend nowadays. I mean, yes. See, you got full creative control. He sound like you talking about wrestling or something. But yeah, that's true. Homeschool, you know everything that's going on. You know everything that's going on. And with, since it is your child, you know how the best way that they learn. You know how the best way that they receive information. And sometimes some stuff can hit different when it comes from somebody else other than a parent. But he said, everybody can't homeschool. I need my job. Understood. I know that. No, but I'm saying for just for our situation with Carter, it just worked out, man. The homeschool worked out for us. And I know everybody's jobs are different. Everybody's jobs are different and everybody's situations are different. So to each situation is different circumstances or whatnot. So I completely understand you with that, Coach. And I know some people just, they wouldn't want to homeschool, man. Some people just want that break from their kids. They're like, oh, go away. That part I can understand too. Because I needed that from Carter earlier today. Because I was, oh boy, we were going over reading. And he was reading. Then all of a sudden, he just shut down. I say, Carter, come on, let's read this. He just staring at me. Carter, come on, let's read this. He's still just staring at me. Carter, let's read this. Nothing. So I needed a little break too. But my wife, her job has allowed her, since this whole thing started going on, her job has allowed her to work from home too. So she's been here. Now with her job is more, scheduled would be the best word. Her job is more scheduled than mine, because you know, with mine is all over the place. But it's with mine, it's more like I'm able to get up and go. If I need to go somewhere, I can just get up and go. Blah, blah, blah. What's up, Carlo? It's cool, coach. I'll pay you to teach mine. There you go, coach. There you go. So you got some side money too, man. So you got the regular job and you got a side job teaching Carlo's kids at the crib, man. So you're set now, man. But with her job, it's more on a schedule. But with mine, it's like I could work on some stuff, work on some videos and whatnot, teach Carter this, teach Carter that, blah, blah, blah. Come work back on some more stuff, go over something else with Carter, so it's just, I'm just super grateful, man. I'm super grateful, man. Because things wasn't always like this. So, it's cool, man. It is, definitely appreciate the situation, man. And with the quarantine, I know, but it's scary. I do really feel bad for a lot of people, because it has impacted a lot of people in so many negative ways. Because with, like, servers at restaurants, waiters and waitresses, they can't do their job. They essentially lost their jobs for a while. Don't know how long it's going to be for. But that's, what's up, Ravens gang? But that sucks, man. They can't do that. They literally cannot do their jobs. It's not a thing where they got fired or they got laid off from it. No, they can't do their jobs. Because ain't no restaurants open. Well, at least the sit-down restaurants. McDonald's and stuff, fast food and stuff, you can still go through the drive-thru. But a lot of that stuff ain't even open. So they can't even do anything. And then I was talking to one of my boys who works at City Furniture. Can't do nothing. Hey, appreciate it, Mike. I'll see you next time, man. Thank you for coming through, man. He said his job shut down. Who else? George, what's up, man? How's everything going? How you and your daughter doing, man? Well, I ain't seen you in a minute, man. My dad owns a DJ business, and spring is peak season for them because of weddings and such. They have zero events scheduled for the foreseeable future. Yeah, man, it's tough, man. It's tough, man. A lot of stuff. Even people that work at, like, the theme parks and stuff, they can't do anything, man. Yeah, Melvin, you're right. See, they were working for tips and they working for tips and whatnot. You can't get nothing now, man. It sucks, man. I was a bartender and I'm pretty screwed right now. Oh, see, yeah, it's tough, man. It's tough for so many people, man. So many people. And I know they're supposed to be sending out the $1,200 and all that, blah, blah, blah. But I mean, that's cool or whatever, but like, people that'd be a nice little chunk of change real quick, but that's gonna go like that. Cause you know, Bill's gonna eat that up, man. Bill's gonna eat that up, man. Oh, my gray beard is chasing yours? Oh, I gotta keep it clean, man. Can't imagine if I was planning a wedding. Yeah, man. People getting married or trying to get married. What are they gonna do now? So it's like you might just have to go to the courthouse. You save a lot of money, but still, I mean, you wanna have the party. You, of course, the marriage is the most important thing. That's first and foremost, but you still want, hey, appreciate that from Puerto Rico, man. But you still wanna have the party, man. What's up, John Moore? Nah, you ain't missed nothing, we chilling, man. But it's so many people that got affected and impacted in a negative way with this whole thing, man. So if your job does allow you to work from home, please be grateful. Please be grateful because, oof, your friend was supposed to get married in Greece. Mm. But yeah, if your job allows you to work from home, be grateful. If you still even have a job, please be grateful. Because it's a lot of people that don't. It's a whole lot of people that don't, man. My grandfather's sick and fighting for his life right now. Hey, man, I'm sorry to hear that, man. Oh, I think I was just talking to you on Instagram, I think, right? Like an hour ago, right? Work from home 3 days a week, have to go in the other two. Hey, well, that's good, man. Appreciate you, King. That's good, George. That's good. Oh, how you say your daughter was doing, man? Because I ain't see the message. That's what's up, coach. So, yeah, man, it's rough, man. So everybody getting hit, man. Oh, you been at home for 3 weeks. Well, that's good, man. So I feel for people who don't have work right now. Oh, good, man. Cool, man. That's good, George. Appreciate you coming through, man. Carter's good. He's good. Big, he was just in there playing Mario Galaxy a little while ago. He's doing good, man. So I appreciate you asking, man. Subway still got me working, so it's cool. That's good, man. That's good. All right, so with the Ravens. I know y'all know how these streams go. We always get off topic, but that's the best part about it. That's the best part about it. He said, I need to get a haircut, manscapist. Oh, this guy. you're wild for that, man. You're wild for that. So, the biggest thing with the Ravens, the biggest challenge for the Ravens. Well, we 51 minutes in and we ain't even answered the question. Man, that's why I love streaming, man. Praying for everybody. Be appreciative for being able to take another breath on this earth, even though we're going through difficult times. It's true. AK said, biggest challenge is coaching. They have not been able to make adjustments when we're down by double digits. That's a piece of it. But I think the biggest challenge, I don't even think it's in the regular season. It is coaching. And the biggest challenge is not whether this team is going to be able to, they're going to be able to pull it all together. The biggest challenge is, for me, I don't think it's them even making the playoffs. But I think it's really what they do when they get there. What they do when they get there, the execution, the coaching, the play calling, the play style, how they attack, how they come back, like my guy Keeping It Real just said. It's just so much with coaching. And again, the biggest challenge is themselves. It's themselves, it's their coaching. Coaching is themselves, it's the execution. The execution is themselves. It's them. They are their biggest enemy. And they have been their biggest enemy for a while now. And that's no disrespect to the teams that have beaten them, like the Titans, like the Chiefs, like the Browns. I don't know why when I said the Browns I laughed, but it's all love, man. But Ravens, their biggest problem, man, is getting away from who they are. That's their biggest thing. And it's like they make all these moves, which is great. I'm loving the moves that they've been making. I absolutely love it. Love it. I'm feeling it. I love the Calais Campbell move. I like the Derek Wolfe move. The Chris Moore, I wasn't a big fan of. But it's cool. I can understand why. They try to get Peanut, ain't work out, blah, blah, blah. Well, we ain't even got to talk about the people they try to get. But the people that they brought in, okay, cool. And whoever they draft, okay, cool. But the thing about going into this season, especially from what we've been through the past two seasons, and again, not complaining, because a lot of... Oh, my God, Terry, what's up, baby? You would be in here for that Browns comment, man. But... He's scared, man. But... Oof. My guy just sent me a message on Instagram. He said, I wonder if we would have been in a Tom Brady market this offseason if we hadn't drafted Lamar. You never know. You never know. We'll never know. Never know. And I'm glad we don't. Anyway, Ravens are just, they've made so many different moves this offseason. And they're going to still make more moves and whatnot. And they're going to build, what's up, Stark Jeter? They're going to build a nice team. They're going to build a nice team. No, George, he said if they wouldn't have drafted Lamar. So if they didn't have Lamar, he said he wondered if they would have been in the Brady sweepstakes. Appreciate that, Jackson. Thank you, man. But they could go undefeated in the regular season. But there's still going to be this thing in the back of all of our minds. All of our minds. As Ravens fans. As realistic Ravens fans. It's going to be in the back of all of our minds. What are these dudes going to do? How are they going to show up in the playoffs? What's going to happen then? Yes, funny looking, this is life. What are they going to do then? Because that's been the thing. And I know a lot of people get mad when the analysts, when the commentators, when they say this and that and the third, they say, oh, the Ravens, they just can't do it in the playoffs. 0-2 in the playoffs since Lamar took over. But you can't be mad at them. That is one thing. That is one thing that the commentators say that you cannot be mad at. You can't be mad at that. Because it's true. Like, a lot of the commentators, they'll say, and I even saw somebody comment it the other day, but a lot of the commentators, they'll say, oh, Lamar, like they said all last year, Lamar ain't gonna last. We saw how that went. Lamar takes too many hits. Again, we saw how that went. Lamar, he's going to have a short career with his play style. Now, that's still to be determined, but again, you got to refer to the first two. He does not take no crazy amount of hits. Again, when somebody in the comment section said that the other day, and I told them, I said, I can tell. I can tell. What's up, Janar? I said, I can tell that you don't watch the games. You don't watch them. Oh, appreciate that, John. Thank you, man. Appreciate it. Just like woke me up, man. Appreciate that a lot, man. He like threw me off, man. I forgot what I was. Okay, but oh, with Lamar Jackson, they think he takes too many hits, but he doesn't. He doesn't take a lot of hits. But that's one thing that the commentators would be saying. And a lot of people would be, since they are commentators, since they would be on TV, they'd be like, oh, yeah, they're right. But they really weren't. But if they say that about the playoffs, what have the Ravens and Lamar Jackson done in the playoffs? They got all the right in the world to say that one. And that's one that cannot be refuted. It can't be denied. It cannot be argued. It cannot be debated. Because they haven't done anything. No, Sir Meeps a lot. You can stop spreading that false news. Nobody believes it. I gotta give you a timeout. You're spamming quite often. And you're spamming lies, too. I don't want you to have anybody from Team Keep It Clean believing that. And I don't think anybody will believe it anyway, because there ain't no video on it. If we ain't do no video, so hey. No, you ain't gotta believe that. But anyway. I tried to untime him out. It's only 3 minutes anyway. Ain't no big deal. But yeah. No, I know nobody believed it, but no, Matt Judon did not get traded to the Chiefs. But anyway. Playoffs, man. Them playoffs have just been ugly to the Ravens. Ugly. 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 It's coaching over Lamar's performance when it comes to playoffs. Two years ago, it was definitely, appreciate that, baller. Can we talk about USC wide receiver Mike Pittman Jr.? Just give me a little minute. But I appreciate that. Thank you for that donation, man. And 2 years ago in the playoffs, the Ravens, they stuck to their plan A. It's too much. They didn't have a plan B. They did not have a plan B. They didn't have a backup plan. But then this year in the playoffs, they went to their backups plan. And they did not stick with plan A that had got them there. I just wish that Ravens would have learned from their mistake from last year or from 2 years ago, but they didn't. What's your thoughts on the added spot for the playoffs? He said, after how many years the Ravens battling for the sixth spot and shrinking out, now they have a seventh spot. I hate it. I absolutely hate it. I do not like it at all. Don't like it one bit. Don't agree with it. Think it's soft. Think it's weak. Think it is garbage. Think it's basura. I do not like it. I don't even care. Yeah, the Ravens done missed the playoffs by one game for a lot of years, over the years. I hate it, though. I hate it. Because, again, it's just watering things down. It's watering things down. And it's like, hey, oh, you didn't make the playoffs last year. Oh, we feel so bad for you. You know what? Instead of actually building a better roster, being a better team, executing your game plan better, and winning some more games, you know what? We got you. We're going to add a playoff spot so you don't even have to work as hard throughout the regular season, and you still make it. You like that? It's like, come on, man. Ain't nobody want that. Like, and again, I know some people did use that same argument about the Ravens missing out on it by a couple of games, whatever, or by a game. But I don't like that, man. Rohan said 8-8 might legitimately make the playoffs now. I hate it, man. Dwayne Williams said, last time people said the Ravens can't win in the playoffs, they ended in New Orleans, Super Bowl. I'm a Steelers, I remember. No. Well, Ravens had been winning in the playoffs. They had won playoff games the previous 4 years. They had won at least one playoff game each of the previous 4 years, sometimes two playoff games. But in two of the 4 seasons before the Super Bowl that they won in New Orleans against the 49ers, in two of the 4 seasons before that, they had went to the AFC Championship. One of the AFC Championship games was, I think, against the Steelers, and the other one was against the Patriots. Because I think Flacco rookie year, they went to the AFC Championship game, right? Was that Flacco's rookie year? Or was that a divisional game? I think that was AFC Championship game. With Willis McGay, he got popped. Oh, boy. That was rough. Oh, that game. Oh, I remember that game, man. Oh, that was a long time ago, too. That thing hurt, man. But again, no worse game than the Patriots one. No game tops that. None. No game tops that, man. Would you rather have prime Mike Wallace or prime Torrey Smith? Prime Torrey Smith. Get more pass interference calls. But, oh boy. That thing was tough. That misfit. Oh, man. Big yikes. It's been 12 years? Oh, wow. We're old. I'm old. Wow, 2020. Oh, yeah, 2008. Wow. I am old. What if Flacco retires this? If he retires this year, that would be so weird. Being able to say, like, wow, he said, and we still lost the Super Bowl. But still, man, y'all had won like 80 of them. Well, back then, y'all had only won like 75. But, yeah, now y'all won like 80 of them, so it was no big deal, man. If Flacco retires, that'll be kind of weird to say, like, man, I watched this dude's whole career. That'll really make me feel, I already feel a little old. That'll really make me feel old. And then my boy George was talking about my whites. That's all good, though. I appreciate it. Flacco to Torrey was the greatest PI connect. It really was the greatest pass interference connection, for real. It was, man. He said, sir, you're under arrest for supporting the worst team in NFL history. Oh, so I'm free because I'm not a Browns fan. Patriots will sign Flacco or Newton or both. That would be fun. I really want them to sign Flacco so bad. Oh, man. I really want them to sign Flacco so bad. One, because I want to see him with Bill Belichick. And then two, I would want to talk to all the Patriots fans that hate Flacco. Because that'll be so fun. Can you please talk about... Oh, we're going to get there, man. We're going to get there. But, yeah, Ravens, their biggest problem is themselves, man. Themselves. So they know what they need to do. Flacco on the Patriots, that's interesting. Yeah, I would love it. I would be with it. So hopefully it happens. Probably won't, but I'm still hoping. Until he signs or retires, I could still hope. Because what they got, Stidham, Hoyer. Get Flacco, man. Or get Cam. Cam would definitely be something brand new with the Patriots. Woo! Oh, yeah, we got 200 people in here. Make sure I leave a thumbs up on the video, man. Michael Pittman Jr. Ooh, 6'4". You know them USC wide receivers. They all be big, man. They all be like giants. Remember, back in the day, what was his name? Was it Mike Williams? Off topic, but did you see the Chiefs? Yeah, I did see that. Chiefs got $177 in cap space. I have never. Ever since I've really been following football and following the cap space, I have never seen anything like that. Ever. When I saw that today, I said, what? Like, what? I had to do a double take because I thought it was like a typo or something. I thought it was a typo, but it wasn't. Hey, what's up, Panthers Rule? What's going on? The other day we was talking about mental health. Want to help me with that type of channel? Let's do this, brother. I would be the worst. I could barely help myself with this channel, man. It is very. I tried to do two channels at the same time. Y'all saw what happened. Well, those of y'all that was around back then, y'all saw what happened to the gaming channel. Like, cause I started doing I made a Madden channel this past July or August. I made a Madden channel. Cause I'm like, I don't want the Madden videos on this channel too. I want this channel to just be football. Then the other channel, Madden videos. Made the channel in August. Haven't uploaded to it since September. So, yeah, that was a big yikes. Big yikes. And then I don't even remember the last time I played a ranked game. I just played my boy Kev tonight in an unranked game. But I haven't played a ranked game in months. Ever since I started playing Franchise, none but Franchise, man. None but Franchise, man. That's it. I'm hooked on it. It is very addictive. Franchise is the best, man. I love it. And I go through the different seasons and what's up, Thomas? Did I record the Hollywood Madden game? I did. I got to edit it. That will be the only Madden video that does go on this channel. Shout out to Hollywood, though, man. Shout out to Hollywood, man. I got to see if he's still following on Twitter, man. He might have been like, man, this dude is spammy on Twitter. Unfollow. But nah, it's all good, man. That was cool. That was fun, man. That was fun. I shouldn't have been greedy though. I got cute. I got Ray. That's why I said I must really be attached with the Ravens because I did Raven stuff in that game. It goes to overtime. It went to overtime. But oh, okay. Oh, I feel you, man. Oh, okay. Just come through a little every now and then. I don't know much about it. I mean, I wouldn't mind talking about it, but yeah, that's cool if you do end up doing it. But we were in overtime. And I was running on him and he couldn't stop my running. He thought I was running out the clock, but I was just running. Cause I the run was working. And then I saw Miles Boykin. I saw the corner pressing on Miles Boykin. And there was no safety up top. I said, ooh, I done got him with Miles Boykin earlier. And it was Marcus Peters who was on him, but I wasn't really paying attention to who the corner was. I didn't know it was Marcus Peters until after I threw the ball and Lamar threw it short and Marcus Peters caught a pick. Yeah, I played against Hollywood on the, it was on Ravens YouTube the other day on this stream. I recorded it though, so I'm gonna probably work on that tonight and hopefully, because I was hoping to upload it on Saturday, but so much stuff started happening on Saturday, but it's all good. Yeah, I wanted to talk to him. I invited him to a party, but my thing it was just not working. It was just not working at all. I had my iPhone headphones plugged into the controller. It wasn't working at all. I could hear him, but he couldn't hear me. So, my wife, she was making fun of me that day. She was because I kept saying, I said, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? And she kept making fun of me repeating that, man. But nah, yeah, he was cool, man. The thing with him, with Holly, the thing that made him so tough, it wasn't none of his big plays. It wasn't even that annoying wildcat that he ran. I hate the wildcat, man. Remind me of Chickers. Chickers is so frustrating with that wildcat. But that wasn't. What's up, Sang? What's going on, man? It wasn't even the wildcat or his big plays, especially to himself. The thing that made Hollywood so tough. Was his control with Lamar. This dude, he like to a T, man. This dude can make Lamar stop and go like that. And I can't control him like that. I can't control nobody Madden like that. But he got that thing down pat, man. Down pat, man. I don't know how he does it, but I couldn't do it. And I couldn't, and that was the toughest part because I couldn't get a tackle on him. I wanted to get a big hit. I wanted to get the strip for the fumble. And we got one strip for a fumble, but his team picked it up. Oh, that was annoying. But, nah, he was cool though, man. He was cool. So, we'll see. We're going to have to run it again sometime, man. Maybe set up something special, especially while all this stuff is going on, man. Ha, yeah, he's seen it in real life. Yeah, so yeah, that's true, man. Oh, he said that's his boy, that's how. Yeah, yeah, that's true. That makes sense too. But yeah, I had to be disrespectful. Well, I guess it ain't really it kinda is disrespectful because I was spamming him with him. I was spamming him with him. Cause my first two or three touchdowns came to him. My first touchdown, it was Marcus, I think Marcus Peters was on him. Over the bomb, over the top, touchdown, long one too. Then the second touchdown, I don't know, I don't remember if it was to Boykin or back to Hollywood again. But my Hollywood got like two or three touchdowns in the game. His got one for sure. Maybe he got two. I don't remember. But his Lamar was going off. Oh, it was annoying. But anyway, it's Chickens you playing, of course. Well, yeah, Chickens with that. But no, I'm talking about with Hollywood, man. When I played him, he, with that Wildcat, he ain't break too many on. He did break a few on me, but not too many. But he's cool, man. Yeah, no, I have a mic, but it just wasn't working. I haven't gotten a party in years. So it is what it is. Like I said, I know some people were like, man, you gotta talk to Hollywood. Whoa, Chris Hall, what's up, man? I was like, it's okay, no big deal, man. There'll be other times, there'll be other opportunities and whatever. It's cool, man. It's cool. So Madden ain't going nowhere. I mean, ain't nobody going nowhere really now. But nah, it's all good, man. I traded Lamar Jackson, the 5th round pick, for Breeze and Michael Thomas. I couldn't resist since I love Michael Thomas. Hollywood won. He won in overtime. So yeah, man. So I'm gonna edit the video very, very soon. Like I said, maybe tonight. So I can have it and edit it and put it on here, so people can watch it if they want. I mean, I'm gonna let Hollywood know next time. I'm gonna get him, man. Straight up. So anyway, back to them USC receivers. Is my guy still in here who wanted to talk about Michael Pittman Jr.? I didn't want him to think we was ignoring him or anything. Are you still in here? I know his name like was like EG3 or something like that. I forgot exactly what his username was. Yeah, it was a good game, Byron. It was a real good game. It was fun. But I was just I was happy, man. It was cool. How would you react if we signed Marcus Golden? That'd be cool. It'd be a nice little underrated signing. Cause I know he's a decent pass rusher. So it'd be a nice little underrated signing. One of them under the radars. Yeah, next time, man. But yeah, just being able to play was cool. So, yeah, man. Madden was glitching, though. They were doing that thing where you can't pick a play. Where it just sits there. So you got to pause the game, then unpause it. So you're using one of your pauses, and then you can pick a play. So it's glitching a lot. Mike Pittman got a YouTube channel? Really? Hollywood got a YouTube channel too. He really got a YouTube channel? I might have to check it out, man. I want to get on 2K Neighborhood a lot, so NBA players be joining a lot. Oh yeah, because they got time. They got time, man. They got time. So yeah. I forgot. I think it was the Lions cornerback or Lions linebacker. Or was it the Lions running back? One of the Lions players said, what's up, Shock Trauma? One of the Lions players said that with the whole quarantine thing, that the people that make Madden really need to reflect on how bad of a game it is. When I saw that, I said, yikes. 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 Whew. I hope people, with the whole 2K coming back in 2021, I hope people are not expecting no competition with Madden yet. Because they're going to have some hearts broken. Because 2K, they already said, 2021, yeah, they're going to be able to do NFL games again, but it's not going to be simulation. It's not going to be simulation. So what that means, it's not going to be no regular football game. Might be like an arcade game or whatever, even though I know some people are going to be like, oh, well, I'll take it. It's some different than Madden. But it's not going to be your regular football game, man. It's not. So Madden will be better when I be on the cover. Ooh, it'll be Blitz 11-11. We'll see, man. We're going to see. But it's not going to be no regular football game. We'll see what they do. That'd be cool if they made like a GTA sort of, not without the violence though, and all the extra not team keep it clean stuff, but sort of if they made like an open world football game, that would be so cool to me. If they let you, obviously you couldn't, well, maybe you could play the game, but they said it won't be simulation. But if they could just take you through, like, something like sort of like Long Shot, but just better and more open, and you could do more stuff. That would be cool. That'd be cool. I'm not buying Madden until they fix Lamar's fumbling. It's Madden is the weirdest thing. Lamar's fumbling. I don't know what his fumbling is. I think it's like a 90-something. But his injury is a 90-something. It's like a 94, 95. It is so weird. Every franchise season I play, everyone, he always gets hurt. Always gets hurt. And usually, at a minimum, it's for like 4 to 6 weeks. He always gets hurt. I'm like, man, like, what's this? His injuries are up. What's this about? Yeah, and he fumbles a lot too, man. He fumbles so much. I'm like, that's not realistic. That didn't happen in real life this year. It's supposed to be based off of how it was this year. And I know y'all done updated this roster like 50 times. You got Lamar at what, a 92, 95, 96, 90-something. And then even my Lamar in franchise mode is a 99. So it's like, man, I done put in work with him, man. But I don't get it. It's the weirdest thing. Open world football game would be awesome, or even like a 2K thing, like 3v3. Yeah, if they could do something like that, that would be cool. Like how 2K does the park and stuff like that, but just more open than that, like an actual game where it's open. Like I said, like a GTA or something. And if they, yeah, since it wouldn't be simulation, if they did do something like 3v3, 5v5, if they did something like street football, flag football, and it just, it would be something. It would be different. And it would take a lot of people some time to get used to, but that'd be cool. But if they could just incorporate football and, I don't know, man. Pause the football talk. Did you watch Tiger King? My wife did. She, and with her, she will start a show. If she starts a show, she is going to finish. If she likes the show. If she starts a show that she likes, she's going to finish that show. She started the show. I don't know when she started it, but she finished it. She liked it. I haven't watched it. I don't even know what it's about. But, yeah. Just a better story mode. Like, if you ever played Tony Hawk. I used to love Tony Hawk games, man. I used to love those, man. Love Tony Hawk. Oh, hold up. Did I miss something? Oh, Janoa. Thoughts on TJ still recruiting players after getting cut? I love it. That's big, man. That shows how greatly you feel about an organization or company. That's like if somebody got fired from their job. Even if they knew it was coming. They got fired from their job, and somebody who applied there is like, hey, what's how is it there? Even though they got fired, no, hey, it's a great company, man. Go there. You should work there. They're good people over there. You should definitely go. It'll be good for you. That's a beautiful thing. That's when you know you really love a company, and you loved your time there, and you really respected your time there. For my old job, the last job that I was doing, I would definitely tell people to work there, for sure. Ain't no hard feelings. There's no hard feelings, because had they not gotten laid off, then boom. We wouldn't be on no stream right now. For sure. But yeah, back to Tony Hawk. Tony Hawk, it was nice, man. Loved it. RTV, what's up, man? Tony Hawk, that game was too fun. I remember when I had, was it Dreamcast? I remember, I don't know, if anybody had was it Dreamcast that I'm thinking of? Or Sega Saturn? No, Dreamcast. When Dreamcast, oh yeah, Underground. Yeah, man. Oh yeah. Man, I gotta get a Dreamcast again. I wanna show Carter Power Stone. I think he would love that game. Especially since it's a fighting game, but it's not like a violent fight. It's not like a Mortal Kombat fight. It's more like a cartoony, not goofy fighting game, but more like what else? You gotta keep it clean on here, Talkin. We got to keep it clean, my friend. Power Stone and Smash Brothers. Yeah. But I like how it's just open. It's just open. I love that. It's open. He said the biggest problem for the Ravens is the Steelers. What's up, Joey? What's going on, man? Before Smash Brothers was a thing. I don't think Power Stone ever really took off like that. Really, Dreamcast didn't. But one thing I used to love about Dreamcast is the demo disc. I used to love demo discs. Because you would be playing all these different games and stuff. It would be a little frustrating because it's like, oh, you would beat it and then, oh, that's it. Okay, you got to buy the game. It's like, argh. But you ever thought about doing interviews with the players during the off season? I mean, I should reach out to them now because they got some time, man. That Avengers game coming out. Oh, yeah, I forgot it. It's coming in May already? I thought it wasn't coming till next year. You sure? You know what I loved about Dreamcast? What's that, man? Yeah, the game did look good, man. And me and Carter, we just beat the that Ultimate Marvel Alliance, whatever it's called. We just beat that last week. So that was good. You played Power Stone, same? Okay. Yeah, man, I might have to find me a Dreamcast. Oh, he said he's sure. Okay. Alright, cool, man. I'm with it. I gotta buy another controller, man. I gotta buy two more controllers then, cause Carter and my wife, we could all play together. Hold up, is it okay? See, there we go. See, Javon, that's what I had heard. That is coming out later. See, Javon, I think Javon heard the same thing I heard. Let me just look it up right now, so we all will know. Avengers video game release date. He said, what if I'm stuck on a boss level in that Marvel game? Sonic was cool, man. Let me go to GameStop. GameStop will have it. Marvel Avengers. Or GameStop. Oof. Release date, September 4th, 2020. Let me go to Best Buy, because Best Buy will certainly have the right date, too. Marvel Avengers, PlayStation 4. Release date, September 4th, 2020. So, yeah. That's not coming out in May. Let me just go to Target for the last one. Target will be the last one that we check. Even though we got two September 4th from two legitimate places. Target is... September 4th, 2020. So there we go. So GameStop, Best Buy, and Target. September 4th, 2020. So now we know. So there you go. That's that. Didn't I work at Corn Dog World in Miami? No, I never did. Is Big Ben okay? Because it looked like he got bigger. Well, that means he was definitely okay because he's been eating good. Biggest threat in our division? I think Steelers because they were quarterback play away. They were a decent team. Their defense, they held it down. But they couldn't get no good quarterback play. So it was their end result. Steelers, Bengals, I think Bengals next year. Not this upcoming season, but you never know, but I think Bengals next year. Browns, they get the right coaching. They could be something serious too. So it could be right back to AFC North being competitive again. It could be right back to it. Also, oh my God, Bobby Palmer, he said no threat. But another big threat to the Ravens. The Ravens, because you know how they do. The Ravens, they don't play their game. You know how that goes. So, biggest threat in the league, the Chiefs. So we'll see. I mean, they with $177, I mean, you can't even sign your draft picks. But you know some changes coming. Sammy Watkins probably going to be out of there. Sammy Watkins alone, I think he creates like 14 mil. Chris Jones, if they end up trading him, and he don't play on a franchise tag, then that will create, I think, 18 mil, something like that. What is he? They assigned him as a defensive tackle. So yeah, I think it's 18 mil. Defensive lineman, 18 mil. Then boom, you got money again. Sammy Watkins, once he gets cut, boom, you got money. But then what happens with Chris Jones, if you sign him to a long-term deal, or if you get rid of them, that's a bunch of money right there too. So Chiefs will be just fine. I said on Twitter, and I like tweeted the whole thing. Like while I was writing it out, I started thinking of more, and I was like, oh, because I was like, first I wrote like, how do you have $177 in cap space? But then, biggest threat is the Zebras. That's one. They weren't too bad this year with the Ravens. They really weren't. In the Steelers game, the first Steelers game, when Devin Bush, when that ball hit the ground, I was like, wow, they really called that an interception. And then in the same Steelers game, when on another interception from Lamar with Mark Andrews, he got interfered with when the ball was on the way. They didn't call pass interference. Then I think Harbaugh even threw the challenge flag, which he should have. But they didn't call pass interference. Or did he throw the challenge flag? I don't remember. But that game, in the Bills game, they were really bad, especially toward the end. Those only two I can remember off the top of my head. But they weren't too bad with the Ravens this year. But anyway. I really forgot what we were talking about before that. Maybe the comment section will help me. Oh, biggest threat. I think somebody said biggest threat in NFL. The Chiefs. Oh, Mahomes crying to the refs. I remember that too. But yeah, the Chiefs. Oh, we were talking about the $177. That's what it was. But I was tweeting it out and I was like, man, how do you have $177 in cap space? But then while I was still tweeting it out, I was like, wait. And then I kept tweeting. I was like, well, if my team had just won a Super Bowl, then I'd take it. I'd love to be in that position. I wouldn't mind that at all. Try living 30 miles from Buffalo as a Pats fan. They're winning the Super Bowl for the next 10 years. It's whatever. As a fan of the game, I'm excited to see if Lamar elevates his game next year. I know he's dancing a lot. Yeah, hey, he should be, man. He got stuff to work on. Yeah, he had a really great season this year, but he still got stuff to work on to be even better. And I'm sure he'll be fine. Like I said, I think his touchdowns are going to go up. I think the interceptions are going to go up, but I think the touchdowns are going to go up too. Because I think he'll be just playing in more games. Just be playing better. Just be playing more open ball. And when I say open ball, I think just they're going to open it up more. So, we'll see. But, yeah, I would not be, if the Ravens had $177 in cap space, I wouldn't care. If they had just won a Super Bowl, I said, okay, well, they know what they got to do, and they'll be fine. I would not be worried about it. I'd be like, okay, I'm with it. We just won a Super Bowl. If we ain't got no cap room, okay, I guess we ain't going to draft nobody or sign nobody. And this year, we're going to play with what we got. Okay, I'm fine with it. Because we just won a Super Bowl. I would not be mad at all. Ravens versus Cowboys would be a good matchup. Ravens got plenty of good matchups this year, man. Plenty. Maybe if they play the Cowboys for the Thanksgiving game, maybe they can get it on a Thanksgiving game. You know Cowboys got to be on there. But that'd be nice. Have Lamar on the Thanksgiving game, prime time versus the Cowboys. M&T Bank. Ooh. I hope Ravens don't get the flip-flop schedule again. See, that's the thing. I did not like this. I don't think, I highly doubt, because that was only the fourth time in NFL history that schedule was given out. So there's like almost no way that happens again, 2 years straight. But it worked out for them. It worked out big time for them because it didn't allow them to, I mean, except in a playoff game, but it didn't allow them to fall flat. It didn't allow them to come off flat. You see that Tyrod Taylor is excited to lead the Chargers next season. I'm rooting for Tyrod Taylor, but I do not think that the Chargers are going to give him a shot to start. I really don't. I don't see it happening. I don't think it's going to happen. I just don't. I don't think that they're going to give him a chance to start. You don't think Tyrod's a starter? I think he's a straight starter. I think maybe it's just his game, but because he hasn't been that lighted up quarterback. He protects the ball. He takes care of the ball. He'll score some touchdowns, but he ain't lighting it up. He's like, to me, he reminds me of a Teddy Bridgewater. Teddy Bridgewater seems like that. But we'll see. We'll see what he does now. Now that he's officially a starter now. And it's going to be his team. It ain't going to be, it's not going to be, I just got to take care of the ball. I just got to chill because this is Drew Brees' team. No, it ain't going to be that no more. Chargers got a crazy defense adding Chris Harris. Oh, I forgot they got him too. But it's not going to be that anymore. Now it's Teddy Bridgewater's team, so he can do what he wants. He can do what he wants. So I'm happy for him, man. Firestone said, do you think once Lamar becomes a better passer, the Ravens will start to have more passing plays to reduce the risk of injury? I don't even think it wouldn't be to reduce the risk of injury. It'd be to just get more passing plays and more developing passing plays and letting these guys go through their route tree and use their route tree. So, yeah, it ain't got nothing to do with injury. It's just with him becoming a better passer. So, that's it. I know, like, a lot of people are, like, they think that this guy, like, Lamar is getting hit a lot. Like, he's getting, because he really is not. The only time he got hit was he got hit in the 49ers game. He got hit in the Rams game. He got hit in the Jets game. And there was one more, I think. But the fact that I got to try to sit here and remember the time, like, when he really got hit. Not like tackle, but when he, like, got hit. It wasn't many times, man. It really wasn't. So, yeah. Oh, yeah. Tyrod is a Super Bowl champion, my friend. It was the Bills game. Yeah, because they were back-to-back with the 49ers. It was the Bills game. You're right. Yeah, Tyrod Taylor's a Super Bowl champ. So, you can't speak ill of our guy Tyrod Taylor. Because you're talking about a Super Bowl champion, Tyrod Taylor. And Tyrod Taylor been a Super Bowl champion for 7 years now. My guy Tyrod, Super Bowl champion Tyrod. Who you think Eric DaCosta is going to pick in the first and second round this year? I know your EDC be talking on the low. I keep saying it's either inside linebacker or wide receiver in the first round, and whichever one he doesn't get out of those two, in the second. So if it's not a receiver and it's an inside linebacker in the first and a receiver in the second. So if it's a receiver in the first and inside linebacker in the second. I'm scared that they're going to go after Lamar Knees, which scares me. Some people will. They will. Because, again, Tony Gonzalez, he said, hey, I'm a Hall of Famer. So I know football. This is how you got to take Lamar Jackson out. Go for his knees. Injure him. Man, I'll never forget that, man. I was like, wow, Tony Gonzalez, you are really, like, wow. Wow. But, hey, and none of them, like, stopped him, I don't think. None of them were like, hold up, Tony G, what you talking about? No. I was like, wow, he said it. He said it. Should work for the Ravens? Oh, that would be something. Never know what could happen, but it's all good, man. I am thirsty, so I'll be right back. Wow, so much better. So much better. Wow, do you think we'll get Jadeveon Clowney? I think it is a big chance that they do. I think it is actually a realistic chance that they do. But that would be, obviously, if they got rid of Matt Judon. I don't know why juice, any juice that we buy, we could just go ahead and cross out the expiration date, because it's never going to make it that long. It is never going to make it that long. Juice at this house? Oh, no. We don't even, like, that. Like, just now, that was the first time I even checked the expiration date on juice. Because it don't last. Like, it'll last for a little bit, but it don't, like, be going the next day. But it ain't going to last no expiration date. Like, and I saw the juice that I just drank. It was passion fruit. Is it Minute Maid? Whatever it was. The juice, Donovan, you know what I'm talking about. The expiration date said June 1st. I said, what? What? That ain't even gonna last till May. What are we in right now? March? It's about to be April. That ain't gonna last the first 2 weeks in April. Ain't no way. So it definitely ain't touching on June 1st. Oof, that would be the day. When some juice lasts that long, oh no. Oh, no. But anyway, probably about to get off of here in a little bit. Do you think if the season started today, we would contend? Yeah, for sure. I drink the juice when I come out the store. But yeah, they for sure would. Oh, you drink it with that Chipotle, huh? Chipotle, you got to have a soda with Chipotle. Chipotle best with a soda, man. Because when you burp, you got even more room to even eat even more of that big burrito. So, man, Chipotle, real deal, man. Man, I be getting tired of wearing this jacket in videos, but it's the easiest jacket to put on because it's not a hoodie, so I ain't gotta put it over, and it's not hot, so I can just put it on, zip it, done. That's it. Do yourself a favor and try POG juice. It's a mix of passion fruit, orange, and guava. It's the best juice I ever had. Huh. I ain't no big fan of guava, but I would try it. I would try it. It's old Moe's. Welcome to Moe's. Moe's, man. Moe's is so good. Me and my wife, we used to go to Moe's. And then I always tell her, I said, you sold out. Because we went to Chipotle, and we ain't never go back to Moe's again. What does Tucker play robot? Who's Tucker? Oh, what are you talking about, Carter? If so, no. Favorite fruit? Oh. I don't know. Dragon fruit is really good. Let me tell you a fire combo. My wife put me onto this. If you take a watermelon, and then get dragon fruit. Buy dragon fruit. And you cut the watermelon in half, and you cut the dragon fruit, take the little seeds out or whatever, but put the other part inside the watermelon and eat it together. Oh, it is so good. It is so good, man. It's so good. It's so good. He said Chipotle and Moe's got beef. I like that one, man. But it is so good, man. If you ever get the chance, do that, man. It is so good. So dragon fruit and watermelon. White or red dragon fruit? I think red. Man. Now you're asking me these tricky questions, man. Have you had the Snapple rain drinks? Those are so good. Snapple rain drinks? No. Last Snapple I had was I had Snapple apple. I love that. So, what does dragon fruit taste like? I don't even know, but it's good. It's really good. But again, you mix it with the, you put it in the watermelon. I'm telling you, man. It's so clean, but it's so good, man. Like it's sweet. It would be like you would feel like the way that it tastes, because it tastes so good, it's like you're drinking juice. But at the same time, it would be like, oh man, this is so good. And it's clean. Bobby Palmer said, how much you want to bet Flacco goes to the Jets? No, you don't need it. No. Who they got as their backup, though? Do they still have Luke Falk? Because they got Sam Darnold, and I don't know who their backups are. Oh. Signed XFL Cam Phillips for 1 year, 1 mil. Matt Judon will be going. You think Matt Judon going to be going? We'll see. Yeah, I want Flacco to go to the Pats, but we'll see, man. I really do. But, and if not Flacco, then Cam. Either one, I'll be cool, man. Saints say Flacco retiring. We'll see. Flacco to the XFL. Yeah, get off it. Don't do that, man. DeAndre Swift to the Ravens. It's almost draft time. Almost. It's about to be April. Well, in a day. In one more day. It'll be in April. What a month March has been. What a month, huh? You think we can get that fast wide receiver from Kentucky? Recording at midnight. Oh, yeah. Well, we live at midnight. So, yeah. Hey. It is what it is, man. Sorry. Dark horse pick. A safety at 28? Oof. I don't think they would do that. I mean, anything possible, but I don't see no safety in no 28. Your first round pick on a safety, and you got Earl Thomas and Chuck Clark. So you got safety for at least the next year. Depending on how you feel about old Earl. So we'll see how it works out, man. But nah, that boy said a dark horse pick of safety. 28. Oh, Grant Delpit, that's the dude from LSU? Yeah, LSU. Shout out to Coach, man. I watched Coach video on Grant Delpit the other day, man. So I don't know if he's still in here right now. He might be knocked out, but yeah, Coach did a video on Grant Delpit the other day, and I was watching that one. I was like, okay. So, but I don't see. He said Earl kind of overrated. No, Earl was straight last year, man. Earl was cool last year. Ravens season prediction? Like 11-5, 12-4, around there. I mean, hopefully they could be even better than last year, but that's wishful thinking. It's not unrealistic for them to be as good or even better because the team is going to be better. The team should be better. The defensive line should be better. Got the same cornerbacks. Brandon Carr is gone, but we'll see what happens there. But got the same coordinators. That's big. A little scary for the playoffs as well, but yikes, we'll see. We'll see. Mims might be a late first rounder. He's shooting up draft boards. Oh, yep, I keep hearing everybody talk about Denzel Mims. I've seen that the Pats have 892 in cap space. Yeah, I mean, but I'm sure they're probably looking at Chiefs like, man, we rich, we straight, we can sign anything we want. But $177? Like, that don't even sound real. That don't even sound real. Draft the kicker in the first round. Okay, that would do it. What's up, Oz Raven? What's going on, man? So, anyway, I'm about to get off of here now because I'm a little hungry. I got some work to do. So appreciate y'all, man. Appreciate you, Antonio Gamble. Thank you. Shout out to my guy, John Moore. Shout out to Carlo Iron Addict. Appreciate y'all donating. Thank you for that. I love y'all. Appreciate y'all. You know, YouTube, boy, YouTube take that 45% of that, but it's all good, man. So I appreciate it anyway, man. Thank you. Thank y'all for even being willing to donate. Thank you for all y'all coming through. He said you've been donated more than the Chiefs cap room. Just a tiny bit less. But I appreciate y'all. I thank you all. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. Follow on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. All that stuff is Engraving Vids. Love y'all. And thank you. Thank you for being a part of this. Thank you for coming through. Thank you for taking the time out of whatever you were doing on this Monday night. Whatever you were doing. Wherever you are. Because I know some of y'all in different parts of the world and stuff. Thank you. So I appreciate it. So love y'all. you a fool, Josh. So I am about to get to work. Got some more editing to do, and I am hungry. And yeah, so I love y'all. I will see y'all tomorrow in the videos. Appreciate it. And be good, be safe, be smart, be out.